Hello everyone, in our today's video we will discuss the topic balanced diet in detail. This is a topic of unit 2, sports and nutrition. Let's move on with today's topic. A balanced diet, we already discussed the meaning. Let's repeat or rediscuss it once again. A balanced diet is the diet in which all the components are present in appropriate or required quantity, and the ratio between proteins, fats and carbohydrates should be 1:1:4. Now these are certain factors on which a diet is based on or must be based on. We must consider these factors while planning the diet. Number one is age. Diet must be according to the age of an individual, because if we consider a child who is growing, age is 1 year or maybe 6 months, the diet cannot be same as a 50-year-old man, because child need more protein because growth is taking place rapidly, where older age people don't need that much protein. So diet must be based on the age of an individual. This is the first factor we must consider. Second factor is climate. If people are staying in high altitude or colder climate, they must take more fats in their diet. They must take more proteins in their diet, because digesting proteins and fats keep body warm, and they are going to help the individual to stay warm in those cold climates. Next is gender. Male and female differences are there. We call them gender differences. Males are generally taller, broader, larger in size, and females are comparatively smaller and shorter. So as per size consideration as well, and as per the body requirements also, male need more calories compared to female. So diet must be accordingly. Next is profession. Profession is a very important factor while planning the diet. If someone is doing a non-physical activity job, for example an office job 9 to 5, in which individual is sitting on chair, working on computer or laptop, not doing as such physical activity, and on another hand, if someone is doing labor work morning 9 till 5, someone is doing strenuous physical activity, doing labor, physical labor, diet must not be the same. It must be accordingly, because the caloric requirement of that individual who is doing labor work is for sure going to be more, and the caloric requirement of individual who is doing office work will be less. So diet must be accordingly. Next is body weight. If someone is already obese or having overweight, they must take less fat in their diet. They must go for more fiber food and more nutritive food. Nutritions and vitamins and minerals must be more. And if someone is willing to gain weight, who's slim and who's thin, must go for higher quantity of proteins and fats. Specific sports diet. It is very, very important for sports persons who are taking part in multiple games or sports. If a player is taking part in cross country or long distance races, the carbohydrate is going to be a very crucial factor. More of the caloric requirement will be fulfilled by carbohydrates or glucose, we can say. So the diet must be carbohydrate rich diet. And if someone is taking part in combat games using power and strength, they must take higher level of proteins instead of carbohydrates. So according to the nature of the game and requirement, the diet must be planned. Next is pregnancy and feeding mother. In this particular situation, the diet must contain all the important factors like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, all must be present in appropriate required quantity, because a mother is going to feed a child also, and in this particular age, diet is going to play a very crucial role. So it must be rich with nutrients and minerals and all. Next is diet during health problems. If someone is recovering from some physical injury or some disease, diet play a very important role. So diet must be planned accordingly, and minerals and vitamins and proteins must be there in appropriate quantity, because these are crucial factors or components of diet which help in recovering from injuries and diseases. They are helpful in enhancing our immunity. Now we will discuss the functions and importance of balanced diet. We can also call it the needs, functions, importances, as well as needs of balanced diet. Why we need a balanced diet. These are certain points which we must consider while having a diet. These are the reasons why we need it. These are the importances, and these are the functions of diet. What diet do with us. First thing is energy. Every human need energy to move their body, to stay alive, to keep their body functioning. Energy is the main requirement, main function, and main importance. And food is the only source of it. A diet which contains all the required nutrients and components will provide us proper quantity or amount of energy required by the body. Next is optimum growth and development. Now, food and food supplements and food components are required for proper growth and development as well. Because if we are not taking proper quantity of proteins in our diet, the growth will be affected. If we are not taking minerals and other components, development might be affected. So it must be a balanced diet. It is another very important role. Next is proper functioning of organs. Human body organs also need energy to function, and diet is going to provide that energy, and diet is also going to maintain our hormonal balance, because human body used to work on chemical reactions, and those chemical reactions are directly concerned with our diet. If we are taking all the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients, our body functions will be normal. Next is faster recovery. If we are taking a proper diet, we will recover from injuries and diseases faster. Next is strong immune system. If all the nutrients, vitamins, minerals are there in our diet, our immunity will be better. Next is improve fitness level. The fitness level for sure is going to be better if we are taking a proper diet, proper nutrition. Our fitness level with obviously physical activities and regular exercises going to be better. It is not possible just with diet that someone can be fit. We need to do regular exercises also. Next is improve metabolism. A metabolic process is the process which gives energy and process our body energy system. With proper diet, as all other functions and systems work well in the body, metabolic process also works properly. Next is prevent deficiency or diseases. Deficiency means lack of some nutrient, and it improve our immunity. Accordingly, it prevent us from diseases also. A proper diet keep us away from any kind of deficiency and disease. Maintain body weight. If we keep diet properly, means if we are eating as much required, we are taking the components of diet in the required ratio, required quantity, we can maintain our weight also. But if we are going to eat more and we are going to do less workout, we will for sure going to gain weight. Next is overall efficiency improve. This overall efficiency basically means quality of life, standard of life. If someone is healthy, the level of satisfaction with life is obviously going to increase. The quality of life will be better. Individual will be conveniently performing all the skills, all the tasks, and the individual will be more happy and satisfied. The quality of life will be better. And this is it with today's class. Thank you. We'll discuss other topics.